So let us now apply the mechanical energy conservation theorem to a slightly more involved problem. A problem where, you know, say, first of all, it's not just one block, it's two blocks. Also, where things are not necessarily moving simply up or down. Okay, so here, what we're trying to do is, our goal is essentially to find the speed of the two blocks when the 10 kg block hits the bottom. So what is the speed when it just is about to hit the bottom? Now, what we'll do is, again, we'd realize that the coefficient of friction is zero. So everything is frictionless. And since there are no non-conservative forces, we can use the mechanical energy conservation theorem. Now, when we apply the theorem, what we have to do is we're going to find the mechanical energy for the system at the beginning and for the system at the end. Now, to find the mechanical energy, we need kinetic and potential for each of the blocks. For the 10 kg block, everything is simple. In the 10 kg is 2 meters high, so we know that we can take the ground to be its reference point. And from there, we measure the potential energy, and its potential energy will be simply 10 times 2 times 9.8 in the beginning. Let's also assume in the problem that everything starts at rest. So its initial kinetic energy is zero. Now, for the 8 kg block, the same thing, the initial kinetic is zero. However, for the 8 kg block, if you notice, the 8 kg block is currently in the beginning at its lowest point. Once the 10 kg block starts to slide down, the 8 kg block is going to go up the incline. And if you look at the, what would happen to the 8 kg block, it would start somewhere here. It's at its lowest point now, and then it would end up going 2 meters up the incline. Now, here's what we need to keep in mind. The 8 kg block is going 2 meters up the incline, but that does not mean that its height is increasing by 2 meters. In fact, if anything, we need to figure out what its height is. And for this, we draw a simple triangle here. Okay, this angle is 37 degrees. And what we notice is that this side, the height, is equal to 2 times sine of 37. So now we know the final height of the 2 kg block. Once again, what we'll do is, we'll assume the initial height to be zero for the 2 kg, sorry, for the 8 kg block, and then, that'll be its reference point, and then we can calculate everything from there. Okay, so let us write down the expression for the mechanical energy initial, and that is going to be equal to MEI1 for block 1, and it is going to be MEI2 for block 2. Okay, so I'm just going to call the 10 kg block 1 and the 8 kg block 2. And for the 10 kg block, the initial kinetic is, of course, 0. 1 half times 10 times 0 squared. Its potential, however, is 10 times 9.8 multiplied by 2. So we understand that. For the second block, the initial kinetic is, once again, 0. 1 half times 8 times 0 squared. And its potential is also zero, because it is at its lowest point. So that's the one thing that we need to make sure we understand. And if you calculate this, this ends up being 196 joules of total mechanical energy in the beginning. Now, let us repeat this for the end, and we'll have F2 plus MEF1. So it's MEF1 plus MEF2. And when the 10 kg block hits the bottom, what we know is that it has no potential energy. It only has kinetic. So it'll be 1 half times 10 times VF squared plus 10 times 9.8 times 0. So this is all the stuff for the 10 kg block. Plus, now the 8 kg block also has kinetic energy. And since they're connected by a light and inextensible string, it has the same speed as the 10 kg block. And plus, it also, now the 8 kg block, since its height has gone up, it has some kind of potential energy. And once again, remember, the height for that is not 2. The height gain is not 2. The actual height gain is simply 2 times sine 37, which happens to be approximately 1.2. So this is how we get the mechanical energy in the end. And if you were to calculate it, this would end up being 5 VF square plus 0 plus 4 VF square plus 94.08. Now, let's equate the two sides. I get 9 Vf square plus 94.08 is equal to 196. And what this gives us is that 9Vf square is equal to 196 minus 94.08. And that'll end up being 101.92. So this is 9Vf square. And so this way we can figure out what our Vf square is. And it'll be 101.92 divided by 9. It happens to be 11.32. And so now I can find the square root of that and get the answer. I got about 3.36 meters per second. So once again, the process is fairly involved in this. What you have to do is, again, once we recognize that there are no non-conservative forces, you can then use MEI equals MEF. And once you use MEI equals MEF, what you also have to recognize is that the 8 kg block is not going vertically up 2 meters. It's only going vertically up by 1.2 meters. And we got to figure that out using drawing the simple triangle here. And then once we get that, you account for all the terms, for the initial and the final terms. And and then, you calculate the speed with which the two blocks travel. We end up getting 3.36. All right, that's for that problem.